Hey guys, I'm Marissa with DollarSprout, and in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to start a blog of your own. Learning how to start a blog really does have the potential to change your life. Some people start a blog as a hobby. It's something fun to do outside of work, while others start a blog as a side hustle to bring in a little extra income. And for some, blogging has turned into a full-time business. One so profitable that they're able to actually quit their job, travel the world, and live life on their own terms, all just because they started. The great thing about blogging is that it is a low-cost and zero-risk way to open the doors to opportunity that weren't there before. So in today's video, I'm going to be walking you through how to start a blog of your own with WordPress with a step-by-step tutorial. And I'll also be sharing 5 blogging tips and advice, so be sure to stay to the end of this video. I'll be showing you how to start a blog with HostGator. HostGator is a website hosting company, and they are great for new bloggers in terms of performance and cost. And they have the infrastructure to accommodate your blog as it grows, which is really important. You can check out our link to HostGator in the description box down below. And the great news is that we have special pricing with HostGator, and with our link, you'll get the best possible pricing, so be sure to check it out. If you came into this video hesitant on actually starting a blog, let me tell you why other people blog. People have very unique reasons for wanting to start a blog. Some are compassionate in nature, perhaps they want to educate others on a rare form of a disease they or a family member are struggling with. Others are more informative, where they want to chronicle a weight loss journey and inspire others to do the same. And some blogs are entertaining, like a fashion blog. No matter your reason for wanting to start, with the right strategies, your blog can connect you to millions of people, get your ideas out into the world, and can make you more money than you ever could make at your 9-to-5. If you don't think it can happen to you, think again. Just a few years ago, my friends Jeff and Ben started the DollarSprout blog with absolutely no experience. They had no idea how to actually start a blog and didn't know what to even write about. But since then, they now both run the DollarSprout blog full-time, and DollarSprout makes over $1 million a year. There are a lot of other bloggers out there who make over $100,000 a month, like Michelle from Making Sense of Sense, which is another personal finance blog. She took her little hobby as a side hustle blog and now makes over $1 million a year. Melissa Griffin runs a blog to help others grow their businesses, and she's shared how she makes over $100,000 a month as well. Bobby from Millennial Money Man has a blog where he shares about money and side hustles and makes over 6 figures a month from his blog as well. Now, it takes a lot of work to reach the status of these 6-figure monthly bloggers, but that shouldn't stop you from trying. It's definitely feasible to start making a few hundred or even a few thousand dollars per month within just a few months of starting. So how do bloggers make money? The cool thing about blogging is that there is a near limitless number of ways to make money. You can use display ads, doing sponsored posts, affiliate marketing, selling courses, ebooks, or trainings, consulting, or providing another service like coaching or mentoring. To get your blog started, you want to decide on a niche and a name. You want to pick a niche that is specific enough, but also allows you to be able to talk about different subjects in relation to that niche. The DollarSprout blog is in the finance niche and contains topics ranging from side hustles, budgeting, investing, and more. Other niches that people blog about are things like fashion, travel, or even parenting. It's good to have one general niche to focus on so that your readers know that you're the expert in that niche. Like, it would kind of be strange if your blog was about car modifications, fashion, and also money. So it's best to pick one overall niche for your blog. Then choose a name. It's great to choose a blog name that helps to explain what your niche is. Like, when you go to DollarSprout, you expect to learn about money. And when you go to Millennial Money Man, you expect to learn about money tips for millennials. So choose a name that helps to reflect your overall niche. Now let's get into that tutorial to show you how to set up a blog or website. Don't forget to use the link to HostGator located down in the description box to get the lowest pricing available and follow along with this tutorial. So I've clicked on DollarSprout's link for HostGator, and as you can see, there's a hatchling plan, a baby plan, and a business plan. And each one comes with different things, so obviously pick the plan that's going to be best for you and the things that you're looking for in starting a blog or a website. But for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to go with the hatchling plan and hit buy now. Next, we get to search for a domain. So we get to choose a domain name. So I'm just going to come up with a domain here. Let's see. Budgeting is fun. And there you go. This domain is available. So this is going to be my free domain, which is great. We'll scroll down here. I am not going to add on domain privacy protection for the purpose of just this video, but if that's something that you want to do, then you can go ahead and click that button. And now you are going to select your plan, which we decided on the hatchling plan, and then also the billing cycle. So as you can see, if you sign up for a 24-month or a 36-month plan, that's obviously going to give you the best discount. A 36-month plan is going to be only $2.75 a month, so the more months you choose, the less it's going to cost each month. But for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to do 1 month to show you how to walk through it all. And then you're going to set up a username and a PIN. And the next section just has you enter in personal and billing information. And then section 4 has you add on additional services if you want them. So you can read through all of the different options that they have and decide if you want to add any of these to your purchase. But again, for the purposes of this video, I'm just going to go pretty basic just to walk you through it. But there's many options for you to choose from if you want to add any of these. And then there's a section for the coupon code, which is already entered in for you because you followed the DollarSprout link. Another great thing about HostGator is that you get a 45-day money-back guarantee. So they have this also shown up when you're reviewing your order details. And then scroll down and you can see here all of the special pricing that we have. So the amount due is going to be $12.34. You want to click the box saying that you have read and agreed to the terms of service. Obviously, if you want to read the terms of service, go ahead and read it. And now we will hit checkout. And then you get to this next screen when HostGator is doing all the work for you and preparing to set up your account. Now that our account is all set up, we are going to build our site with WordPress. WordPress is the blogging framework that so many other websites use, and so we definitely will want to get started with WordPress. There's so many ways that you can customize it and build your website, and also tons of themes that you can choose from. So we are going to click Get Started with Setting Up WordPress. And here we are just going to click the button Install Now. So we're going to choose the version that we want to install. So I'm going to choose the most recent version. And then here it shows my website, budgetingisfun.com. Then we'll choose the site name. So I'm going to say budgeting is fun. And description, a budgeting blog. Then you can set up your admin username and password here and an admin email. So I'll say marissa@budgetingisfun.com. Next, you can select the language, and then you can also select if there are any additional plugins that you want to have installed. Next, there are advanced options, but I'm just going to go ahead and leave that alone, and then select a theme. So there are tons of different themes available, and so you can kind of view them and see which one is going to represent your style and your branding for your blog. All of these themes that they have here are free, but there are some additional paid for themes that you can view if you want. But there are tons of free themes that you can look through, and you can just click on demo to be able to see what the entire website will look like with this theme. So this one, okay, I'm liking it. I think that it looks good. So I am going to go ahead and choose this theme. I'll just hit select and then just hit the install button at the bottom. Now this is going to take a little bit of time to get everything up and running for the website. And then we get this lovely message showing that the software was installed successfully, so we're ready to go. So once you've set up WordPress, now you can go and start creating blog posts and also edit your site with WordPress. So you can open up a new tab and type in your domain and then /admin. And then this takes you to WordPress, and then you can just enter in that username and password that you selected and then log into your account. So I wanted to show you how you can make a couple customizations of your theme. So how you do that is you go into Appearance and then go to Themes. And here it shows the website theme that we selected when we were downloading WordPress. But there are also some other ones that are available that we can choose from if we want. But you can then click this button that just says Customize. So let's say you want to change the tagline of your website. You can go over here to Site Identity, and then you can show the site title and also the tagline. So we can say a budgeting blog, so we can change that and say, because budgeting should be fun. And then hit Publish, and as you can see, it shows here, because budgeting should be fun. So here on the banner, it shows hospital that you can trust. This has just been the theming that I copied over. So to change that, I can go to header banner and then go to banner content. and then you can update the title and the subtitle and everything that you're looking for here. So here we can just say, budgeting is easy if I spell it right. Help, budgeting is easy. And there we have it updated on our website. And then just hit the publish button to make sure that you save it. So if we exit out of this, it takes us back to our WordPress editor, and then you can get started on creating blog posts. So you can go up to this little pin where it says posts, click that, and then you can click add new. This little pop-up will show you how you can create a blog post, so you can walk through that to get some guidance if you need. And then you can just start typing away on your very first blog post. So why I think budgeting is fun is my title, and then here we're going to start a blog, and I'm just going to start typing away for my first blog post. And when your blog post is complete, you can make sure you save it, which is very important, and then you can even preview. So here's what my blog post looks like on my website. And then when you are ready, you can hit that publish button and have your first blog post published and ready for the world to see. Now that you have your blog set up, here are 5 blogging tips and advice as you get started. Tip number 1, create a logo. This will add some sort of professionalism to your website and adds an element of branding. You can use a website like Canva to design a logo or other graphics for your blog. Canva is a free website with tools for you to create your own graphics. They have templates, or you can just start from scratch. Or if you don't have an eye for design and want a more professional logo, check out Fiverr. On Fiverr, you can hire a graphic designer to make you a one-time logo, and it's also pretty affordable. Tip number 2, get on social media. Using social media is a great way to drive traffic to your website, whether that's from Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, YouTube, or more. There are many different social media platforms to choose from, and that can probably seem pretty overwhelming. My advice is to choose 1 or 2 platforms that you can really master and build up a couple platforms before moving to another. By using social media, you can build up followers and then share links to your blog when the post goes live. Tip number 3, use Yoast SEO. SEO stands for search engine optimization. SEO is important to have your post show up and be seen in results when people search for a certain topic on a search engine like Google. Yoast SEO is a plugin for your blog that will help you with keyword optimization and post writing to make sure your posts have the best possibility of getting found in search. There is a paid version of Yoast SEO, but if you're on a budget, there's a free version as well. Tip number 4, sign up for some affiliate programs. With affiliate marketing, you receive a commission if someone uses your link to make a purchase or sign up for something. There are many different affiliate marketing programs out there, but one of the easiest and best is with Amazon. You can visit Amazon's website and sign up for their affiliate program. From there, you can get your special affiliate link for anything on Amazon's website. And when you share that link in a blog post, you'll get paid if someone uses it to make a purchase. Writing a post on Christmas gifts for your kids? Link those items through Amazon's affiliate program. Tip number 5, search YouTube for website help. Obviously, you're watching this video as a tutorial to set up a blog, but if you are getting going and are wondering how to set up something else on your website, search YouTube for another tutorial. I mean, you can always pay a website designer to make changes for you, but that can be expensive. Or you can learn for free with other YouTube tutorials. So now you know how to start a blog of your own. Don't forget to use the link in the description box below to HostGator and get the best hosting price available. And if you have any questions about blogging, we are here to help. So drop your questions in the comments below. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to the DollarSprout YouTube channel for more videos, and I will look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye.